Hey y'all, welcome to Simply Lizzie. So today we're making tacos. Why? Because Cinco de Mayo lands on Tuesday this year and it's still Taco Tuesday. So if you want to stick around and see how I get these delicious tacos done, and keto style, mind you, then let's go. Okay, we've got about 2 tablespoons of butter that is currently melting. We add on about 2 cloves of garlic. If you add a little bit more garlic, that's fine too. It's all what your preference is, really. I'm just gonna let that heat up a little bit. Ooh, love that smell. Nice and garlicky in here. We're gonna let your garlic burn or anything. This is a perfect time to add your meats. I'm adding ground pork. Then I'm just gonna break it apart a bit. At this point, I'm going to add a little bit of MCT. I kind of eyeball it, but it's probably roughly about a tablespoon or so. You're free to use other oils at this point. It's not required to use MCT. I just do it because I'm trying to make this as keto-friendly as possible. Lower your heat so your meat can start cooking. At this point, I'm gonna add 1/2 of a lime. Make sure there's no seed. And then we're just gonna squeeze it right onto the meat. If you're like me, you don't like that meaty smell on your food, and this is definitely gonna help cut that for you. Our meat's cooking pretty well, and now we're gonna add some of our extra stuff. I'm gonna add about 1 tablespoon or so of tomato paste. I definitely needed more, but that's okay. Sure that gets all in there. And this is also the part where I add all my onions.
It's about 1/2 an onion.
If you're onion friendly like me, you're free to add more, but this time I'm gonna stick to 1/2 just based on the amount of meat that I had. Okay. Now, this is the best part. We get to add all of our spices. All right, so let's see. We've got paprika, cloves, black pepper, cayenne, cumin, slap your mama, but don't do that, turmeric, and we have garlic powder with parsley. We're gonna add all that in. Then make sure we mix it all up. Don't worry, all the ingredients, the specific measurements, will all be in the description box below. So I'm mixing this bad boy up. As you can tell, I use no salt whatsoever. It's really not necessary. If you find, in none of my
All of my spices just have a normal amount of salt. They don't have any extra added salt to it. But this is mostly just to kind of keep it at a low sodium count. If you find that as you're tasting it around this point, that it needs a little bit more salt, then go ahead and just add a pinch or two. Look at that. Look at that color. Love turmeric. That's color to everything. My last piece, this is the second half of the lime. Again, like I said, I really just don't like the smell of meat when I cook something. I want to smell like the flavor. I want to smell the spices that you put in it. So this is why I'm going to add this again. So this is basically just one full lime. And hey, if you forgot the first step, you can add both of this step too. It's quite all right. And one last thing that I like to do, a little piece of butter. All right, we are almost there. Look at that. This is such an easy meal. I mean, you're ready to go. Prep time is probably the longest part, just cutting everything and your recipe and your spices. But other than that, I think you're good. Look at this deliciousness. All right, I'm going to let it cook on low heat for another 3 minutes. And then we'll be ready to take it off the stove. Okay, now let's prepare our toppings. So I'm using the shredded green and red cabbage from Trader Joe's. I normally use this to top my salads as well, but I think it goes great with tacos. It's very simple. These are three ingredient toppings for your tacos. We've got the cabbage. We've got cheese. I'm using this new cheese I got from Costco called Beacon Fell. It's pretty good. So, I mean, don't I sound so unenthused? It's actually really good. Let's just be clear. We're going to use that to top over our Alright, so all the cheese goes in. And then I'm using Chipotle ranch as from Sprouts. It's actually a salad dressing, but I think it's absolutely delicious. So we're gonna use about just 1 tablespoon of it. There we go. And mix it up. And that is it. That is your topping. Your topping is all ready for your tacos. Look at that. Okay, now we're ready to put our tacos together. So this is not pre-made. This is store-bought. This is actually a wrap from Target. Carb Balance wraps from Target. I believe they are 4 grams of net carbs per wrap, so they're kind of perfect for if you're trying to stay keto friendly. These are actually, I don't actually have a taco maker. You can very easily make these just by folding it over in your oven. You can do one with bar or two. This is 2 bars and this kind of gives you that width, but if you don't want that size, you're more than welcome to do it differently. I know some people like to start with the topping first, but I like to start with the taco. So we're going to start with the meat, I mean. So first we start with the meat. It's okay if it gets messy. You're going to eat it anyway. And then top it off with our toppings. I get some good old cheese in there. It's gonna be so good. Some good toppings in there. And look at that. Got yourself.
There you have it, folks. You've got 2 delicious ground pork tacos. Recipe makes enough for 4, but if not, you're sure to keep leftovers. Enjoy your Taco Tuesday and be sure to subscribe and tune in next Sunday for some new adventures. Who knows what I'll make next?